The sky moves. Sideways. This is Moon Loop. It's another longie. It's 22 and a half minutes. I have a feeling I might have heard this as a live one. I think this might have been on the Coma Divine album. So it could be familiar, bits of it, but I've certainly never listened to it on here. So let's do this. The last little bit of this album. And what an album, hey? What an album it is. Let's go. Replenished my coffee.
Thank you.
I've said this before, and I'll risk saying it again. This does remind me of, without trying to sort of blow me on trumpet, as it were, but it is, just sounds like a lot of the music I make or have made in the past. And I never did anything with it. It just all sort of languished on CD-ROMs and my hard drive and bits and pieces going to SoundCloud and a few bits onto YouTube. I really ought to try and do something with it. Probably it's a bit late in life to start doing that, isn't it? But it's... quite a sort of laid-back, incredibly laid-back track. That bass line is really groovy. Untrue. Mm-hmm.
Battery died. Oops.
This is just pure sort of ambient music, isn't it? It really is. It's so orb-like now. It's fantastic. This is a million miles away from, In Absentia or Fear of a Blank Planet. Deadwing.
that's in 7. That's a slightly different riff. So it had nothing like money at all, which reminds me of it.
Exit stage left. Wow. Wow. That's an immense record. Absolutely immense. Incredible. Absolutely just phenomenal stuff. I should never really have doubted it. I mean, I didn't doubt it anyway, because I kind of knew that it was going to be good. But I don't actually think I recognise that last track, Moon Loop. Perhaps that wasn't on the recording the Coma Divine. I thought it was, but it's if it is, it's a very, very different version, because I don't. Well, maybe I've not listened to that bit of it. I don't know. Anyway, so that's very new to me. Very new to me. And it's a continuation of the Sky Move Sideways Phase 1 and Phase 2. Well, it's not a continuation of, but it's in the style of. But very, very ambient, very soundscapey. There's a real marriage between sort of Osric's The Orb and Pink Floyd, and all three of these bands are some of my favourite of all time. So that I didn't know this is extraordinary. Having discovered it is brilliant. I think there's probably quite a bit more old Porcupine Tree of this vein, which I need to explore forthwith, really, as soon as I can. But I need to do other stuff as well, so I can't just sort of gorge myself on Porcupine Tree for the next few weeks and not do anything else. I get a bit boring for everybody. But I will be revisiting this, as indeed I will be Big Big Train, and I'll be doing some Marillion and some... we've got some Orbit Culture coming up soon. New album's out, quite a lot heavier. Loads and loads and loads of stuff. Thank you so much for watching this and for listening with me. I hope you've enjoyed it. If it's your first time listening to this track, this album, I hope you go and find it and get it yourselves, because it is awesome. And do yourselves a favour, listen to it on some good headphones if you can, because it rewards listening like that. And it is such a good recording, and it just, there is so much detail and sonic texture in there. It's wonderful, absolutely brilliant. There we go. I'll see you guys on the next video, whenever and whatever that is. Until then, this is Jim, over and...